Mats, how long you been up here, huh? Setting up ambushes, hitting supply runs. Murderers and thieves, and I can't let any of them escape. One. Gotta finish this. Topping off.
What?
Someone's here. Who was that?
You like stabbing him in the back, huh? That right? You like this. Okay. Finally, Jesus.
Who's out there? Man, come here!
Get in there. catch where you're going, huh?
Okay, here we go.
Almost out.
Charge him! Get him!
That's it. You're done. How do you like that, huh? Being ambushed, you like that? You murdering sons of bitches. I wonder if they had a bunker around here. I'll bet they do.
Thank you.
Here it is.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. Many of you probably don't remember the Cold War, but living through it was a special kind of hell. Every time you heard a plane flying overhead, you'd think for sure that this is it. That's the one coming to drop the big one on us. And we lived through the Red Scare. Man didn't know if his neighbor was an American who bled red, white, and blue, or a communist red to the bone. Made it hard to trust. My father, God rest him, taught me the only way to be safe in dark times was to go underground. Built my first bunker with him. But we couldn't build it out in the backyard, with a neighbor spying. Had to go out into the woods, a ways from the road, where no one would happen upon it. With a bunker, you knew that if the country went to hell in a handbasket, you could open that manhole cover. Climb down the ladder and you'd be safe. With your radio and your hoard of food and ammo. Things haven't changed. Better to dig a bunker than an early grave. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Yeah, Cope? How'd that work out for the poor bastards who owned the one that I just cleared out? Huh? Not so good, I'm guessing. Since they were all dead long before I ever got there. It's like Boozer says, I hear a bunk calling my name.